hate this life, living in a poor house with its mean walls, worn chairs, and ugly curtains. What I really want is to be a bon vivant, to live in an elegant house with chambers, heavy oriented tapestries, vast saloons hung with antique silk, and exquisite pieces of furniture. I want to escape poverty.
We are here.
Yeah. Please open the door. Bonjour, Manny. Here's something for you.
Is this for me?
Yes.
The Minister of Education and Madame Raponneau request the pleasure of the company of Monsieur and Madame Roussel at the Minister on the evening of Monday, January the 18th.
What's the matter with you? You've been uneasy and anxious. Very odd for the last 3 days.
I'm utterly miserable at not having any jewels. Not a single stone to wear. I shall look absolutely no one. I would almost rather not go to the party.
Well, wear flowers. They're very smart at this time of the year. For then, francs, you could get 2 or 3 gorgeous roses.
No! There's nothing so humiliating as looking poor in the middle of a lot of rich women.
How silly you are! Go and see Madame Forestier and ask her to lend you some jewels. You know her quite well enough.
That's true. I've never thought of it. Madame Forestier? Madame Forestier?
Mathilde? I'm coming, Mathilde.
Bonjour, madame.
Bonjour, Mathilde. Come inside, dearie. Please have a seat. What can I do for you? Do you want some café au lait?
Thank you, madame. But no. I'm here to talk this over. You see, I received a letter from the Minister of Education. And I've bought this dress to wear in the occasion. And I came here to borrow some jewelry from you, since I have none. Can you lend me some?
Lend? Of course. I'll go get them.
Great.
Cheers, my dear.
Haven't you got anything else?
Oi, look for yourself. I don't know what's better for you.
Splendid. Can you lend me this one?
Of course.
Oh, thank you, madame.
Bonjour, Madame Luzel.
What's the matter with you, my dear?
I've got no longer the necklace. I mean, Madame Forestier's necklace.
What? Impossible! Are you sure? You still had it on when you came away from the ball.
Wait, I thought it in the hall, at the ministry.
But if you had lost it in the street, we should hear it fall.
Yes, probably we should. Did you take the number of the cab?
No. I'll go over the ground to walk and see if I can find it.
Look, my dear! It's the same necklace!
It's true. And here's the phone number too. You might as well give it a call.
Sure.
Bonjour. How may I help you?
Do you happen to have the diamond necklace in the newspaper?
Oh, you mean this newspaper?
Hmm.
They cost 40,000 francs.
Could you perhaps lower it down to 56,000 francs?
Hmm.
Please, bonjour.
We were done.
Thank you. And please don't sell it for 3 days. We'll be back to pay for it.
Monsieur Luzel had 18,000 francs inherited from his father. But that amount is not enough to pay an expensive necklace. And so, Monsieur Luzel borrows 1,000 from another man, 500 from another, 5 louis here, 5 louis there. He also gives notes of hand, enter into ruinous agreements, did business with usurers and the whole tribe of moneylenders. After doing so much business, Monsieur Luzel went back to the jeweler's shop and paid the necklace worth 36,000 francs. At last, the necklace was paid. So Madame Mathilde went to Madame Forestier's house and takes the necklace with her.
Madame Forestier? Oh, Mathilde.
Oh, Madame.
Bonjour, Mathilde. Come inside.
So, I came here to return this necklace.
You ought to have it brought it back sooner. I might have needed it.
I'm so sorry, Madame.
Well, you are forgiven.
The life of working and paying notes lasted 10 years. 10 years have passed and now everything was paid off. The usurer's charge and the accumulation of superimposed interest. Madame Mathilde looks old now. She had become like other strong, hard-core women of poor households. Her hair was badly done. Her skirts were awry. Her hands were red. But when her husband was at office, she sat down by the window.
I have thought of that evening, long ago, of the ball, which I was so beautiful and so much admired. What would have happened if I had never lost those jewels? Who knows? Just who knows? How strange life is. How fickle. How little is needed to save or to ruin.
One Sunday, Madame Mathilde went for a walk along the Champs-Élysées to freshen up herself.
Bonjour, Madame Forestier!
Madame Forestier, you must have known me! But Madame, I don't know. You must be making a mistake.
No, Madame, I am Mathilde Luisel.
Oh, my poor Mathilde.
Oui, this is me.
How you've changed.
I've had some hard times. And many sorrows, all on your account.
On my account? How's that? But you've brought it back.
Exactly. You haven't noticed it? They were very much alike.
Oh, my poor Mathilde. But mine was imitation. It was worth, at very most, 5 francs.
What?
Oui. An imitation. It was an imitation, my dear. An imitation.
Oh my! I thought it was so expensive. By the look of it, shame of me! How shame of me! Our hard work was just useless for that necklace. That elegant necklace was just an imitation!
And that is how it ended. From this story, we learned that we must be content of what we have and don't be envious of what others have.